Hi, welcome to Sesame Street.
Hi, Louise.
Hi, Telly.
Wow.
Oh, hi, guys. Welcome to Sesame Street.
Wait a minute, Telly, be careful. I don't want you to break my vase. Oh, gotta get the phone. Be right back.
Okay. Yeah. I gotta watch out for Louise's vase. It could break, I guess. Yeah. But, gee. You know, it is kind of pretty. Yeah. I like the way the design moves around. It kind of swirls around this way and goes whoosh, whoosh, whoosh.
Oh, no! Oh, no! This is terrible! Terrible!
Oh. Telly, what's terrible?
Oh, Roxy Marie, I broke Louise's vase.
Where?
Look at that.
Oh, yeah, you did.
Oh. And I know just what's going to happen, too. Louise, get off the phone in a minute. And then he'll come out here and see that I broke his vase. And then he's going to be so angry. I'll bet he'll be so angry that he'll yell at me. Oh, oh, I hate being yelled at. What am I going to do?
Telly, hey, buddy, chill out.
No, take it easy. Oh, he's getting off the phone. What'll I do? Wait. He can't yell at me if he can't find me. Well, That's it. I got to get out of here.
Wait, Telly, wait. Oh, gee.
My vase!
Yeah.
Roxy, what happened?
Well, Telly broke it by accident. You see, he's real upset about it. But he just ran off screaming and said he's going to hide from you.
Hide? Why?
Well, because he's afraid you're going to yell at him.
I'm not going to yell at him.
You're not?
Oh, well, it was an accident, wasn't it? Wow. These things happen.
Yeah, Louise, wow, you're okay. I like your style. Boy, if I ever break something, I hope it's something of yours.
So, Telly broke your vase.
Yeah. It was an accident. Roxy says that he's hiding because he doesn't want me to yell at him.
Poor guy. He must feel terrible.
Yeah, well, look, if you see him, tell him I'm looking for him, but that I'm not going to yell at him.
Right. Okay. Yeah. See you guys later.
See you later.
Mm-mm. What a delicious lunch. A vegetable hero and a tall, cool glass of milk. I can't wait.
Mufford, you've got to make me invisible quick. Can you do it?
Well, Telly, I'm kind of busy right now.
Oh, please, Mufford. I don't want Louise to see me. Please make me invisible.
All right. I guess my lunch can wait a minute.
Oh, thank you. What do I do?
Well, just stand there and relax. Okay, that's it. Now, the magic words. A la peanut butter sandwiches.
Did it work? Can you see me?
Well, I can see you, but I can't see my lunch anywhere.
You made your lunch invisible instead of me? Oh, no. Well, don't give up, Mumford. Keep on trying.
Oh, yes. I'll try again. A la peanut butter sandwiches.
Mumford, tell me quick. Am I invisible?
No, but the crate is. Interesting.
Mumford, Louise could come along any minute. You gotta keep trying.
Okay, here we go. A la peanut butter sandwiches.
Mumford, where are you?
Right here, Telly, my boy. Except for my hat, I made myself invisible this time. Well, sometimes you've got to know when to quit. Sorry, Telly. At least now I can find my lunch.
Telly, Louise is looking for you.
Oh, no!
Good.
Mumford?
Oh, being invisible makes you very hungry, Sevillon.
Hi, it's me, Telly. Yeah, that's right. I'm in disguise as a banana. Yeah. Now, even if Louise sees me, he won't recognize me. Now, and if he doesn't recognize me, he can't yell at me for breaking his vase.
Hey, Joey! Get a load of this!
Well, what do you know, baby boy?
A banana.
Yeah, it's a real beaut, too. Yeah. Hey, what do you say we take it home?
Good idea.
Wow, it's heavy.
Leave me alone. I'm not a banana.
Sure, Mac. Listen, I know a banana when I see one.
Yeah, you're all yellow.
And you're shaped just like a banana.
Yeah, and besides, it says right there on the sign, B-A-N-A-N-A. And that spells
banana.
But I mean, I'm not a real banana. It's a disguise.
That's a hot one. Come on, Mac, you're coming with us.
Ready? Heave!
Oh!
Heave!
Stop it!
Oh!
Go away!
Oh!
Listen! I'm talking! Real bananas don't talk, do they?
He's got a point there, Joey.
Yeah, well, of course I've got a point. Now go away and leave me alone.
Telly?
Oh.
Telly! Say, Luis is looking for you.
Hey, did you see that banana split?
Telly, where are you going with that suitcase?
I'm running away from Sesame Street.
No way, Telly. You love Sesame Street. All your friends are here.
Yeah, I know, but you see, I broke Luis's vase.
Oh.
And I'm afraid he's going to yell at me, so I don't want him to see me. I tried to become invisible, but that didn't work. I tried a banana disguise, and that didn't work. There's only one thing left to do.
Wait a minute, Telly.
Huh?
Did you try talking to Luis?
Oh, no. He won't talk. He'll yell.
No, listen to what happened to me once, okay? It was morning at my house, and my mommy fixed me this special dish for breakfast. Oatmeal with cinnamon.
Hey, yes. We eat oatmeal with cinnamon at my house, too.
No kidding.
Yeah.
Well, so I dropped the bowl of oatmeal on the floor. What a mess.
Mess.
The bowl broke, and the oatmeal went all over the place.
No.
I was really afraid that my mommy will yell at me. So do you know what I did?
What?
I went and I hid under the bed.
You hid under the bed?
Mm-hmm.
That's a great idea. Why didn't I think of that? I gotta go to my bed. I'll see ya.
Telly, wait. Listen.
What?
So I'm under the bed, right?
Yeah.
And I start thinking, hey, I can't stay under here forever. I gotta grow up and go to college so I can be a doctor someday. I can't be a doctor if I'm hiding under the bed, right?
Oh, yeah, I guess you're right.
So I decide to go to my mommy
and
tell her about the bowl of oatmeal. And do you know what she did?
No.
She took me in her arms like this. And then she hugged me like this.
Yeah.
And then she kissed me all over like this. And then she said, Rosita, don't worry about the oatmeal. That was an accident. I don't care about the oatmeal. I care about you. I'm your mommy, and I love you, and I don't want you to be afraid.
Wow. But Luis isn't my mother, though.
No, but he's your good friend, and he loves you. Go and talk to him. Tell him how you feel. Yeah?
You are right. I'm going to go talk to him right now.
Okay.
Thanks, Rosita.
You are welcome.
Telly, where have you been? I've been looking for you.
Please, I broke your vase by accident.
Yeah, I know.
You do? Well, go ahead, yell at me if you want to.
Telly, come on. Hey, it was an accident. I'm not going to yell at you.
You're not?
No.
Oh, are you going to hug me and kiss me all over?
Well, look, why don't we just go over to Hooper's store, have a soda, and talk about things? What do you say?
Really? Great! Gee, Luis, you're a great guy, you know.
I like you too, Telly. Going to hell.
Yes, I love numbers. Naturally, because numbers are used for counting, and I love to count.
Right. But today we're going to talk about one number. The number one.
Yes, I recognize it right away.
The number one can be very useful. I use it when I have only one of something. Like, I have one book here.
One book, yes. But do you know what I do when I have only one book?
No, what?
I use my imagination, and I imagine a whole stack of books to count. Yes, one book, two, three, four, five, six books, seven, eight, nine, count. 90 books, 10,
count.
11, 12,
snap 13, out of it.
16, 17.
Count, count. Count. We're just talking about the number one right now. No counting, just the number one.
Yes, of course, Gordon. Forgive me.
Okay. As I was saying, the number one is very useful. You can use it when you have just one of something. Like, I have just one glass of juice here.
Only one glass of juice? How sad. But with my imagination, I can imagine lots and lots of glasses of juice. Yes, that's one glass of juice. Two, three glasses.
Count.
Four.
Count.
Five.
Cut it
out.
Six
glasses. Seven, eight, nine glasses. Sorry, Gordon. I guess I got carried away again.
Look, I know you love to count, but could you please try to stick to the number one this time?
Very well. I will try. There is only one count.
That's for sure.
And I, the count, have one nose and one mouth.
Right. That's it. Very good.
And one imagination.
No, count.
Yes, and with my one imagination, I can imagine lots of counts to count. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine counts.
Wait, we're gonna play one of our favorite games now. And when it's time to sing, everybody sing, okay?
Yeah.
That's everybody. All right. What are the four things we've got here?
A helicopter.
Helicopter.
Airplane.
Airplane over here.
And a spaceship.
And a spaceship. And a pair of shoes.
A pair of tap shoes, Telly. So let's sing.
Okay. Music maestro. Three of these things belong together. Three of these things are kind of the same. One of these things just doesn't belong here. Now it's time to play our game. It's time to play our game. Yeah! That was great. All right. First of all, let's take a look at all these. How are they all the same?
Because they are black.
That's right. They're all colored black. Yeah. Now tell me, which one is not like the others?
The shoes.
Yeah. Yeah. That's right. All the other things, the rocket ship, the airplane, and the little helicopter are all things that fly. Yeah. But the tap shoes are not things that fly.
So long. I gotta go.
Or are they?
Sesame Street has been brought to you today by the letters U for umbrella and by Z for zebra. And the number one for one guy standing here saying goodbye.
Ah, but if you use your imagination, you can see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 guys standing there saying goodbye. Sesame Street is a production of the Children's Television Workshop. Bye-bye.